this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to animate these abstract shapes. It relies mainly on one technique, and you'll be surprised how easy it is in the end. Hey everyone, my name is Manuel, and let's dive right in. First of all, we need to create and set up the shapes. My comp is 1920 by 1080 pixels, 24 frames per second, 6 seconds long. We double click on the rectangle tool to create a shape. Name it Shape Center. Then let's adjust the size in the shape properties. Let's say 300 by 300 pixels. We use a solid fill, color, black. Let's duplicate the shape, name it as well, Shape Edge. Let's double the size to 600 by 600 pixels. And change the color to gray, 80 RGB. And we move it below in the layer stacking order. Next, we need to create the white shape and the dark gray shape. To do that, and to make all the shapes stick together, we use the Create Nulls from Path Script. Therefore, we need to convert both shapes into busy paths. Select both path properties, right click, and choose Convert to Busy Path. Then, let's draw the white shape. With no layer selected, we choose the pen tool and roughly draw the path. Let's name the shape, Shape Top. We choose a solid fill, color white. Now we need to link the bottom points of the white shape to the top points of the center shape, and the top points of the white shape to the top points of the edge shape. We select the path property and choose the Create Nulls from Path Script. Choose Nulls Follow Points. The same for the center shape. We choose the path property, open the Create Nulls from Path Script, and choose Nulls Follow Points again. And finally, we choose the path property of the top shape and choose the script again. But this time, we choose Points Follow Nulls. We want the points of the shape to follow the nulls. Now, we need to link the nulls of the top shape to the nulls of the other two shapes. The top right point to the top right point of the edge shape. Let's change that view here, makes it easier. The bottom right point to the top right point of the center shape. The bottom left point to the top left point of the center shape. The top left point to the top left point of the edge shape. To move all points of the top shape to the exact right position, make sure the position values of the null objects are all zero. Awesome. And what happens now is, if we animate the center or edge shape, like rotate or scale it, the points follow along. Let's add the bottom shape. With no layer selected, we grab the pen tool again, roughly draw the shape, name it Shape Bottom. Let's choose a dark gray color, 30 RGB. Again, we select the path property of the shape and open the Create Nulls from Path Script. Choose Points Follow Nulls. Let's make more space to see all layers. The top right point to the bottom right point of the center shape. The bottom right point to the bottom right point of the edge shape. The bottom left point to the bottom left point of the edge shape. The top left point to the bottom left point of the center shape. Let's quickly set all position values to zero. Then arrange the layers. The center on top, shape bottom, shape top, shape edge below. To make things easier, we hide all layers except the center shape and the edge shape. We press the Shy switch for all layers except the two hide the layers. Awesome! Did you know there are a lot more resources on my website? Check out my courses, learn how to create smooth animations, or how to animate with expressions in After Effects. Sign up to my newsletter, get your free expression sheet, or download more than 150 After Effects project files. The link is in the description. Let's animate. At the beginning, We scale both shapes up until the screen is completely dark, the edge shape, the small shape to around 650%. Let's set a keyframe for both properties at the beginning. And let's rotate the center shape 90 degrees at the beginning. Set a keyframe as well. At 1 second, we scale the center shape down to around 167%. Rotation, 0 degrees. We scale down the edge shape. Let's move the timeline window down again, so that the height of the edge shape aligns with the comp height. We select the right 3 keyframes, open the graph editor, and adjust the speed curves. Add easy ease, then further slow down the end of the animation. The speed curves. Then we offset the animation of the edge shape by 12 frames. Let's duplicate the comp in the project window and add it to our comp. Start point at 12 frames. We go further back and scale it down so that it fits into the black center shape. Let's rotate it though, 90 degrees. Let's make it slightly bigger, then use the black shape as alpha track mat. Make it visible again. We need to link it to the center shape so that it moves along. And just like that, it looks much more interesting already. And now let's play with it. Next move, we go to 1 second and 12 frames. Add a scale, rotation, and position keyframe for the center shape. Then move on to 2 seconds and 4 frames. We move the position of the center shape to the right edge. Rotate it, minus 45 degrees. Scale it up to around 455%. And scale up the edge shape so that it covers the whole screen. We open the graph editor and ease the speed curve. Select all keyframes, add easy ease in the first step, then adjust the speed curve. Slow down the start and end even more. We go to 2 seconds and 9 frames and set keyframes for the animated properties. We want the shapes to rest in place for a few frames after each move. We move to 3 seconds and 5 frames. Let's move the center shape to the other edge now. Scale the same, rotation the same, the scale of the big shape, 0. Again, we open the graph editor, add easy ease to all keyframes, and further adjust the speed curves. Move to 3 seconds and 10 frames. Add keyframes to all animated properties again. And now, let's rotate the edge shape as well. We add a keyframe to the rotation property. At 4 seconds and 5 frames, we move the center shape back to the center. 960 pixels. Scale it down to 0, rotate it to 90 degrees. And we need to scale the edge shape up so that it covers the whole screen. And rotate it 180 degrees. And it looks completely different. Let's quickly adjust the speed curves again. By animating a few properties, you can create really cool stuff. I bet you'll come up with some crazy variations of this. One more thing. Let's add an adjustment layer. Set the start point at 2 seconds and 9 frames. And add the mirror effect. Make sure the reflection is in the comp center, angle 0 degrees, and it looks like that. On the left side, I've added a video you might like. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye, everyone.